This is the Deka Compound Bow. It was added in Day 4 of CrimeFest 2018, alongside the Claire Shotgun and the TAR-21 Assault Rifle. So this is the first free bow available in the game. Now, you don't need any DLC if you want to use a bow. The other two DLC packs that have bows are the Chivalry Pack and the H3H3 Pack, if I'm not mistaken. So you can take a look at the stats of this thing on the right. This compound bow is pretty much a reskin of the heavy crossbow, stat-wise. The performance is much different, as you'd expect. Now for the mods, you can have an ammunition mod, a boost, a grip, a sight, and an upper receiver. Now this compound bow, unlike the other bows, has a lot of unique mods. The upper receiver, the grip, and especially the sight. So like the other arrows, you can have an explosive arrow or a poison arrow. I don't have either right now. I've modded this thing for concealment, so I have a concealment boost, an ergonomic grip, and the tactical frame. Now, like I said, you can also put a sight. You can pretty much put any sight that you could put on an assault rifle. I have the combat sight. And if you want to, you can use something a little more short range, like a speculator sight. Or if you want to, you can go balls to the wall with a reconnaissance sight. So, like it was mentioned earlier, this is the first free bow available to the game. Now, you could buy the game for like $5 during the sale and get every DLC available, or you could stand by your morals and still not buy any stuff. In any case, this allows all the people that have skipped out on the older packs to use a bow. And of course, everyone's probably wondering, is it any good? Well, as we saw from the stats, we can see that it's pretty much identical to the heavy crossbow and the English longbow. Just conveniently ignore that I forgot that the English longbow exists, and I was saying this is a reskin stat-wise of the heavy crossbow earlier. But more to the point, this weapon is essentially exactly the same as the English longbow and shares the same stats as the English longbow and the heavy crossbow. Hard hitting, but also very slow. It's got a slow draw speed, slow reload, and slow aim down sights. Honestly, it feels really awkward to use. You'll notice in the gameplay that there's this little bob when trying to fully draw the string back, and that really messes up with your aim. That alone makes it much more annoying than the heavy crossbow, in my opinion. But you also don't need to spend about 3 days reloading the damn thing, so it does have that going for it. Now, as you'd expect, you can't really use this like other weapons, and I'd consider it more like a high-powered backup sniper-type weapon. You know, it feels best used in conjunction with a weapon setup that is strong in dealing with lots of weaker enemies. The compound bow pretty much has the ability to one-shot every enemy in the game except for things like bulldozers and turrets. However, when trying to use it against bulldozers and turrets, you're just gonna have a bad time. It's atrocious trying to fight enemies like that with this weapon. The high damage does not offset how utterly slow it is, and you're not able to push out a lot of damage fast against those guys like you would with more conventional weapons. This also kind of applies just for general use. Sure, it has a whopping 2,000 damage, but this damage is totally unnecessary when you're unable to get a lot of kills really efficiently. With the way the game currently is, weapons like this are really weak since Overkill decided to balance the game around an absurdly high amount of enemies instead of giving them more health or something like that. So weaker weapons, they're still totally viable, and in some cases, preferred due to the characteristics about them, while things like the compound bow, they just feel a little out of place. It's somewhat nice for being able to pick off pesky enemies like specials at longer ranges, but at the end of the day, it's still a bow, which lacks the precise aim of a hitscan weapon, and it also lacks, like, penetration or any other fancy characteristics. You also have to deal with gravity affecting the arc of the weapon, and if you really want it to be an anti-special weapon, since it does have a lot of damage, it might work a lot better if you stick to using a compound bow modded with explosive arrows. Then, it'll take care of shields no problem, you don't need the penetration, and you can also take off faceplates of dozers with relative ease. And it still sports high enough damage to deal with most specials, but I can't say whether or not you'll be able to one-shot them anymore without the headshot damage multiplier. Still, from my time using this with normal arrows, it just doesn't really feel all that useful. Actually, I'm gonna go ahead and say that when I use this weapon on Death Sentence, one down heist, I feel like a little bit of a hindrance, you know? I don't feel like I'm contributing a whole lot of kills, and it's a little too high risk for the reward that you're getting. And I get that some weapons feel bad in my hand simply because I lack the skill as a player to make the most out of them, right? But in this case, I want to say that even if you were a super Legolas-type archer, you don't miss any shots, you have picture-perfect aim, you'd still probably have a harder time being useful using only the bow. But that being said, it still has a lot of versatility as a purely backup weapon. You know, as long as you're comfortable with the secondary that you'll use for the majority of the mission, this compound bow can be a fun little backup for picking off enemies from mid to far range, or using it purely to blow up stuff with explosives. The poison arrows, they're not something I play around with much, but I think the small bit of poison isn't really worth the huge loss in total ammo as well as damage. So, this compound bow, it also has really great concealment, which makes it a great complement for crit and dodge builds, further solidifying its role as a solid backup weapon, if that's something that you desire. Another plus that it has over the crossbows is that since it's a regular drawstring bow, if you go into Swansong, you can actually shoot a lot of arrows at your feet for easy replenishing of your ammo reserves, whereas crossbows can't do that, they can't shoot fast enough. Actually, if you were to compare the compound bow to the English longbow, it's probably just straight up better since, you know, they're so similar. But since it has the ability to put on a sight, that just gives it the extra edge. So if you want to use the bows for long range, that sight actually helps out quite a bit, despite the need to compensate for the arrow drop. So overall, the compound bow, it's not like it's a bad weapon. It just feels like it kind of sucks that it's so clunky and awkward to use. Personally, I think I would use a heavy crossbow if I wanted to back up bow type weapon. You know, sure, the reloads take longer than overkill trying to add console updates, but at the end of the day, the slow and clunky aiming and shooting of the compound bow are a huge turnoff.